My name is Esmeralda Maya Lozano, and I work at the Puerto Rican Culture Center in Humboldt Park. We have here, who do we have here?
It's Kevin. Kevin Hernández is my name. Hey, everybody.
Hi, Kevin. I love you so much, and I miss you. How are you?
I've been doing good. It's been a little crazy. Oh, my God. With this whole thing going on. And, yeah, it's just been crazy. Crazy for the pandemic to happen right after I get out of public health, right?
Yeah. So, Kevin, tell me about yourself.
Well, Kevin, I'm 26, actually. I work in the nightlife. This craziness has affected me in many different ways. But I've been trying to be a good soul and steady soul and, like, manage my time wisely. But what do you want to know? I don't know. What specifics did you want to know?
I mean, don't you, so you are a promoter? Where do you promote? Stuff like that.
There you go. So, yeah, so essentially I'm a promoter. So this whole thing has been a little crazy because I basically worked almost every day, whether it was going to a different venue or working at Hydrate, trying to promote different things. There's staying busy. I'm a very hyperactive person. So, like, that job took up a lot of my time. And, like, now I can't even do that shit. I think I was one of the first ones affected with this whole pandemic. With the coronavirus and COVID, I think, right? 19.
Yeah.
Which I don't even know. You know. But yeah, that's a little bit about me. It's been rough-ish. People like me in the industry, I'm a very social individual. So a lot of us are. So it's been very stressful and full of anxiousness when you can't go outside and, you know, be that social person.
Tell me, so how has this affected you mentally, your mental health, physical and emotionally?
Many different ways. Luckily, I've never, like, gone to anybody for my own help with anxiety or any of that, but my anxiety has definitely spiked. My mental health has been pretty steady. It was good, but then I think after the first 2 weeks or the first week after, essentially, I started getting more anxiety. Reach out to friends who have bad anxiety, because anxiety gets the best of us. For me, luckily, I'll either just, like, drop and do push-ups, or I'll go outside. I need to run, but I try not to, or just have my friends to talk to. So, I mean, that's how I've been. I do still go out and be, when I go to groceries, that time is probably my favorite time, especially for people like me. My anxiety goes down, I relax more, which is weird, right? It should be more concerned about time. But I think a lot of people are experiencing a lot of mental health issues right now, whether it's depression, and specifically being depressed sometimes, like being at home, sleeping, not having a schedule, like not being able to work, it really, really messes with your brain. So, yeah. Your virtual communications have been the light of my life lately, honestly.
So you've been going out grocery shopping, but you've been taking precautions just like everybody else.
Yes, and I think everyone needs to, like, be really cautious, because I've encountered a lot of crazy people, like really, really insane crazy people about this virus, which is not a bad thing. I think that we all need to go out there and remember not to take it harshly when somebody else is taking more care of themselves. Because it sucks, and I've seen people like, okay, back off, or like, da da da. So I just let them do that, and I go about my day. I think we need to remember that. It's good to be more cautious, even if you're not yourself, because a lot of us aren't being too cautious.
Right. So my last question that I have for you, Kevin, working in the nightlife industry, how are you coping with this pandemic?
Oh my God. Honestly, I'm very, very lucky to work for the venues that I do work for, especially Hydrate. I'm honestly very, very lucky, but it's been tough because obviously I have no income, applying to different things, there's so many people, but especially nightlife and it being my life, my sleep schedule is crazy messed up. I'm used to it, so I'm up all night and I sleep, not all day because I can't sleep with all the sunlight, but I try to sleep as much as I can, so it's messed me up there. But luckily we have a great owner. We're still able to get paid a little bit. and still party through our entertainment. I'm really, really lucky to be part of a company that really has taken the initiative in this whole virtual social distancing and keeping the fun going, especially with our crowd and the crowd that we do appeal to, which is worldwide. So
right.
It's nice for a crowd such as the circuit crowd now to kind of like get together worldwide every Saturday. So that's how I've been coping, honestly. My job has been helping me with my stressful situations and has been a coping mechanism, as well as not just the burden because I don't get paid.
And I've noticed that you would, like you said, that you are a social person, and we, and people that know you know that you are very social, and I see you posting a lot of stuff about on Facebook. That's how you're coping it.
Oh my God, yes, definitely. Social media has helped out my friends, my DJ friends, my promoter friends, everybody doing shows, the girls, our entertainers, even some go-go's. Like, you know, it's been great. Social media, boom, just share everything, spread the love. And I wish I was out there. I wish, honestly, in this pandemic that I could have gotten into nursing or like something in the medical field. A little bit more than public health, so I could be there. For me, this stuff is like really exciting. Not because of what's happening to us, but like all the new stuff that's emerging and like research. And I wish I could be part of that, but obviously I can't because I'm not trained.
Yeah. Kevin, thank you so much for having us. So I would definitely will be talking later on with you. Any last words you have?
No, just please stay safe. Stay at home. Get what you need and talk to your friends. You don't need to see them. You need to remind yourselves that you don't need to see your friends face to face to talk to them.
Or text them or send them a message.
FaceTime them. Right. Right now is the time to go back to old school. Just do a phone call. Some friends, I've gotten phone calls from friends that I'm just surprised they're calling me to check up on me, and I'm hearing the voice instead of getting just a text message every 6 months, right? So, like, reach out.
All right. Well, thank you, Kevin. I love you so much, and we'll talk later.
Thank you, babe. Love you. Bye.